Republican congressman steps forward to defend the students of Covington Catholic High School and expresses his concern about the chilling effect that this may have going forward. Representative Thomas Massie of Kentucky tweets, "The honorable and tolerant students of Covington Catholic School came to D.C. to advocate for the unborn and to learn about our nation's capital. What they got was a brutal lesson in the unjust court of public opinion and social media mobs." Joining me now from Capitol Hill is Republican Congressman Thomas Massie, who represents the 4th District. That includes Northern Kentucky, where the Covington Catholic High School is located. Welcome to our broadcast, Congressman.
And thanks for having me on, Lauren.
Do you think there was a double standard applied because these students were from a Catholic school and attending the March for Life?
I don't know if they were Baptist or Methodist, if it would have been any different. I think they were targeted because they were conservative and that they were there for the March for Life.
You do.
And so I do.
Is that what made this video go viral, in your opinion?
Yeah, and here's the concern that I have, Lauren. I think this is going to have a chilling effect on other Catholic school groups who may be thinking about coming to Washington, D.C. and to support some of these conservative causes. I talked with Nick's mother, and she said, you know, when I signed the release form for Nick to go to Washington, D.C., I never imagined this would happen.
Of course not.
So that's why it's so important for legislators to take up, particularly me, these are my constituents, to take up for these kids, to let them know that they're always welcome in Washington, D.C., and to try to make sure that they have a good experience. And these things should not be following them back home. It should not cause a school to be shut down and for people to be in fear of their safety.
Right. You have said all along that you waited until the facts were in before giving your opinion because what you were seeing didn't match what you knew to be the character of these students. Mainstream media, several conservative voices, school officials, many Catholics condemned the boys' actions. So I have a question for you, Congressman. What are you going to do to change the social media culture?
It's a toxic culture on social media. A lot of it comes from anonymity, and there's very much a bias on social media. We've had hearings in Congress with, we brought in Facebook CEO and others to talk about this. But I'm going to tell you, Lauren, I don't really trust Washington, D.C. to censor the internet.
Then who's going to change this culture? Is it the media corporations? Are you going to go after them?
Well, I think there should be civil liability. The Twitter account was disabled. I'd like to know who ran that Twitter account. And I think there's a good case against them in the civil courts. Also, there's a case in the criminal courts. Our prosecutor, Rob Sanders in Northern Kentucky, has warned people that he will do an investigation because it is a crime to threaten schools and that needs to be followed up on. So really what you need are the prosecutors to step up. There may be a remedy in the civil courts. And myself, as a spokesperson for the district, I'm trying to step forward and at least give these kids some cover because Nick Sandman did nothing wrong. He should be commended, not condemned.
Congressman Thomas Massie, we're going to have to leave it there. We hope to have you back on the program. Republican from Kentucky, representing the district where Covington Catholic High School is. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me on, Lauren.